This is shoulder arthroscopy probe, which is longer than the knee arthroscopy probe, with marking on the shaft. Marking is used to measure the retraction of the soft tissue. And the tip is around 3 mm wide. This is known as Bissinger rod. This is used to create arthroscopy bottles and put a cannula over the Bissinger rod. This is also used to switch the bottles in between, so also known as the switching stick. The tip should be blunt so that it do not damage the soft tissue. So over the switching stick, the cannula inserter is used. So this is a 6 mm cannula inserter. This is 8 mm cannula inserter, also known as bottle dilator, to make a bottle very easy. These are tissue elevator. This is downward, and this is upward elevator. It is used to elevate the soft tissue from the bone for better mobilization. Similar to upward and downward elevator, there is downward rasp and upward rasp. This rasp has a serrated tip, which is used to create bleeding bone for better soft tissue healing. This is known as ring curet, which has a sharp tip to create bleeding bed over glenoid in the greater tuberosity footprint area. This is suture retriever, which is used to manage the suture in between the bottles. It has a blunt tip. And this is soft tissue grasper, which is a serrated tip to hold the soft tissue and check the retraction. This is reusable suture passer, which has a sharp tip and a hollow cannula inset, which pass a metal wire like this. It is 45 degree right. Similarly, there is 45 degree left and straight curve suture passing device. These are spear and crocar for banker trigger anchor insertion. This is for mini beam PK and mini beam PK knotless anchor. This is for 2.8 mm. This is 3 mm double loaded suture anchor. This is 2 prong spear, which is also available in fish mouth design. After removing the trocar, you can insert the anchor specific drill bit to create a pilot hole in glimmer. And it has an auto stopper so that it will stop once the desired length is drilled in the bone. These two instruments are used for insertion of rotator cuff anchors. This is punch and this is punch tap. There are two laser markings here. The first laser marking is for insertion of middle row beam fix PK anchor, and the second laser marking is used for insertion of beam fix LR anchor, that is lateral row anchor. And this punch tap is used when the bone is very hard to make the anchor insertion smooth. This is knot pusher device. It is used to pass sliding knot inside the joint. This is for thumb, and the tip is blunt if tip is sharp and damage the suture material. This is suture cutter device with the sharp tip. It is open-ended suture cutter. This is crochet hook. It has a dual feature. It is used for pulling the suture as well as pushing the sutures. This is hammer. It is used for insertion of punch and the punch tap inside the bone and for the anchor insertion. These instruments are used for bicep stenosis. This reamer is known as fluted stenosis reamer, which is available in 5, 6, 7 and 8 mm. These are not cannulated. It has a sharp tip so that it can be used without guide wire. It is used for insertion of beam fixed PK suture anchor for bicep stenosis. This is the measurement device for the tendon diameter, which has 5, 6 and 7, 8 mm slots.